All right, let's talk a little bit about the brain this week. Because our question for this week is, how does my brain work? And we're going to explore this over the next 2 weeks. But there are just some things that I want you to get out of the videos and the reading and the lecture this week. So there are really 4 main things that I want you to learn about the brain. Okay, the first thing is that your brain is plastic. And you might be like, nope, Miss Gilbert, my brain is not plastic. I've seen a brain before, doesn't look plastic. So I'll come back to that in a second. Number 2, the brain loves repetition. We need to leverage that as we're studying and working in school. And number 3, the brain likes connections. Again, something that we can leverage as we're studying. And number 4, exercise makes the brain better. Okay, so let's talk about that first one, how the brain is plastic. Okay, so what I mean by the brain is plastic, there is this concept in neuroscience called neuroplasticity. And basically it means that your brain can change, that your brain can grow and adapt, that you can create new connections in your brain. Have you ever heard before, because I know I did growing up, that your brain, all you had when you were like 10, was all the brain connections you were going to have, all the neurons that you were given. And if you messed up your brain, then that's all it was going to be, you know? Like, sorry if you had some bad brain habits, like you lost those neurons and you were never going to get them back again. And while not all of that is wrong, it is wrong that I cannot create new neurons and new neural connections in my brain as an adult. Because that's not true. I can grow new neurons and I can grow new neural connections, right? Those connections between my neurons. And so this matters to us because we know that we're not stuck. Okay, we talked about this a little bit in mindset the first week of the semester, but we're not stuck. We are not, as Brusino says, chained to our current capabilities. We're not stuck. And we're not stuck because our brain is plastic, right? Because I can create new neurons in my brain. I can create new neural connections. And so something that I'm not good at right now, I can get better at it. Right? I can establish new neurons about that. I can create new neural networks about that. And the more that I practice those, the better I'll get. And I love that. I love that I'm not stuck. I'm not stuck because I can change my brain. I can grow my brain because of neuroplasticity. It is such a powerful concept in education. And in anything, really, like, I really would have said like 5 years ago, I hate conflict. I avoid all conflict, which was true. But conflict resolution, just like math, is a skill. And I can practice that and I can learn how to work it better. And then I can get better at it, right? Because of neuroplasticity. Okay. Number 2, the brain likes repetition. There's this kind of like movement in education, has been for a while now, like we need to do like something new every day and we don't want our students to be bored and we need to be engaging them, which is true, but we kind of have done that at the expense of repetition, and our brain loves repetition. Okay, and so I want to encourage you to use repetition as you're studying, and then not like my boss likes to tell her students, you're not a vacuum cleaner. Your brain doesn't work like a vacuum cleaner. You can't just like go over it and go over it and go over it. First of all, normally when my students tell me they studied by going over the material, what they really mean is that they had their notes out while they were watching Netflix and texting their friends. Okay, and that is not an effective way of studying. We'll talk more about study strategies later in this semester. But you are repeating that information. When you repeat that information, then it does stick in your brain. For example, my kids, right? I told you I homeschool, and my kids are learning their multiplication tables right now. So even my little, like, 6-year-olds, but we have put it to song, right? And so I can tell them 3, 6, 9, and they're like 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, you know, and they can go all the way up to 15 times 3. My babies do not know, even know what multiplication is, okay? But they know their whole times tables. Like, I think we're on 12s this week, right? Because we put it to song and we're repeating it. Repetition is awesome. Number 3, the brain likes connections. Okay, so when you learn new things, and we talked about, we'll talk about this a little bit when we read chapter 5 next week in College Success, but your brain likes to see connections between things. So when you are acquiring some new information, you need to stick that with what you already know, right? Again, you're establishing a new neural connection, okay? And the more that you repeat that, the better that it sticks. And so you can see how really how those first 3 things work together. But when I get new information, I take some time and I figure out, what do I already know about this thing? Tie it into my previous knowledge, okay? And that will help it stick in my brain better. My brain loves connections. So anytime you're learning something new, I want you to think, what do I already know about this? How can I connect it to what I already know, right? It just makes that learning more durable, right? It will last longer. It'll be easier for me to remember it for my quiz next week or whenever I need to remember that information. Okay, and number 4, exercise makes the brain better. So you're going to watch a video from Dr. Rady this week, and his research related to exercise in the brain is just incredible. And there are so many benefits for your brain with exercise. In my Comp 1 class, we talk a lot about exercise in the brain, and we talk about this book called Brain Rules. But basically, his whole premise is there are things that we can do for our brain besides studying that will help us be better students, right? And if somebody tells me, man, I can make better grades, but I don't need to study more, cool, what is that? So exercise is one of the main ways that we can do that. Exercise primes our brain for learning, right? So it's especially helpful right before or right after, right before I do my studying or right before I have my really hard class. Exercise helps me regulate, right? It like turns on my frontal network, right? The CEO part of our brain is what Dr. Amen calls it. But that like problem solving, figuring things out, logical thinking, all that happens here. And this it turns on when I'm exercising. Okay. It also turns off the emotional part of my brain, right? So exercise is so good for us, especially if we're feeling stressed, if we're feeling anxious, if we're feeling afraid. Exercise can take us out of that feeling for a while, feeling depressed, right? Oh my goodness, Dr. Rady is going to share with you this study about Zoloft versus exercise. And guys, they have the same effects. Isn't that crazy? Exercise is so good for your brain. It's so good for your brain. I really, before I started doing this reading and talking more about the brain in my classes, I really just thought, okay, yeah, exercise, I know that that's good for my brain and it will help me, you know, like not have Alzheimer's when I'm 75 or whatever, which is true and good, but it's hard for me to like get up early for a goal that I won't be realized for 40 years, you know, like that's hard. But when I hear that no exercise helps me now, it helps me manage anxiety. It keeps me from being depressed. It helps me think clearer about problems that I have. It'll help me figure out solutions to the problems that I have. It helps me remember new information better. It helps me build stronger neural networks. Like, sign me up. So, for a bonus this week, you're going to do some exercising for me. If you want to, which I highly recommend. The sweet spot for your brain is that aerobic zone. So you want like 60 to 70% of your max heart rate. What that looks like practically is you can still carry on a conversation with someone. It's not like we're talking right now, you know, but it's not also like what I sound like after I've done 20 burpees, right? Which is like nothing because I can't talk. So that is the sweet spot for that. There hasn't been as much research done about resistance training. So if you're somebody that likes to go to the gym and lift all the time, that's awesome. It's still good for your body. But there's not as much connection research about how that's good for your brain. They've done most of their research related to cardio activity. So this week, I don't have any requirements on what kind of exercise you have to do, where you do that exercise. You can take your dog for a walk. You can go for a run on the treadmill at the gym. You can take a kickboxing class or do some HIIT class on YouTube. Whatever you want to do there. They'll just take a picture of you doing that activity or of that activity, and then you'll send it to me. So that is our video for the week. Our four takeaways about the brain. Number one, the brain is plastic. It can change. You can improve your brain. I love that so much. Number two, your brain likes repetition. So build some repetition into your study strategies. Number three, the brain loves connections. So always tie new information into old information that you have. And number four, exercise makes the brain work better. Have a great week.